Time now for Final Exam, where we pit contestants who follow the news against one another to see who's been paying the closest attention. We've got a double special edition of Final Exam today. Our two contenders this evening have married each other, not tonight, but years ago. Rachel Campos-Duffy is regular here on Fox. Her husband is a member of Congress from Wisconsin, Congressman Sean Duffy. And hopefully this will strengthen rather than divide their union. It's great to see you.
Thank you.
You're brave.
Good to see you, too.
We've never done this. We're plowing new ground here.
I'm excited to be part of that.
Okay. Well, we're excited, too.
Okay.
Now, you know the rules, but I'm going to repeat them for the sake of people watching at home. I'm going to ask the questions. The first contestant to buzz gets to answer the question. You must wait until I finish asking it in order to answer. You can answer once I acknowledge by saying your name. Each correct answer is worth 1 point. If you get it wrong, we detract a point. The cruel math of Final Exam. Best of five wins.
All right.
Okay.
Are you ready?
I'm ready.
All right.
Is there any way I win this, Tucker? I mean, I think I win, I lose.
There's
right
literally no chance. And by the way, winning doesn't mean I actually get you a victory. Yes, you know. That's another show entirely.
That.
Okay. So according to the rules laid out by the National Game Show Commission, all of today's questions must be either about food or animals. We went with food. So the first question is this. It's multiple choice. Please listen carefully. President Trump says he doesn't care what lawmakers call the border wall and offered a food-related suggestion. Which name did he suggest? Was it A, quarter pounder with cheese, B, pancakes, C, peaches? I think it goes by definition to your husband. I'm sorry. The judges have weighed in on this.
I'm going to go with C, peaches.
You're going to go with C. Is it peaches?
Whatever you want to call it, it's okay with me. They can name it whatever they can name it. Peaches. I don't care what they name it, but we need money. Peaches.
Peaches.
Peaches, you both knew that.
I did, and I thought the question was
over. You know, you knew
mistake.
It too well. I think
I
that's
did.
What it
so
was.
So she has to wait for it. All multiple choice have to be.
That's
okay,
correct.
Sorry,
you have to wait till we finish asking the question. Okay.
Okay.
We'll see. We can do it this time. I know. Yeah. Costco, the store, says it is sold out of a 27 tub of food that has a shelf life of 20 years. What type of food was it?
Oh, that was not, that's
Rachel.
Not right. I hit it first.
It was macaroni and cheese.
I think you have to hold it down.
Oh, okay. I hit it first, for
it
sure.
It was macaroni and cheese. Is it macaroni and cheese?
Everybody loves macaroni and cheese,
how'd
but
you
now
know
you
that?
Can get 27
that's
pounds
my
of it, which
that's
apparently has a shelf life.
How many,
of
how many shows
years? We have 8.
Okay.
That's
you
not
need,
fair.
You obviously need to invest in that.
Yes.
Because that seems like a pretty good deal. I'm getting one myself.
I'm kind of a prepper, so I was like, I'll do it. I'll buy it.
I'm kind of a prepper,
it
too.
For
don't
years,
admit
so
that on TV.
Grandkids.
Remember, your official position on prepping is, oh, that's crazy.
I don't want to
yeah,
say
no, come on, no. No, I trust the system. Okay. Question 3. Another multiple choice. Okay. A world record was set this week for the most liked Instagram photo ever. The picture doesn't feature a famous person or an exotic place. It has already nearly 50 million likes. It's a plain, boring photograph of what? A, a banana, B, a lemon, C, an egg. Congressman.
I'm going to go with Kylie Jenner, I believe, and C, an egg. Didn't she tweet the egg out?
I have no idea.
Let's check it out.
But I'm not a member of Congress. Is it C, the egg?
World record egg. An account with that very name posted this single photo. It's a picture of an egg. The egg currently has 26 million likes.
How did that?
And counting.
I'm saying, either you live in this country your whole life and you still don't understand it. What is that?
Dude, there must be like an egg commission that promotes eggs. They're getting a bonus. They're getting a bonus on this one.
The poultry lobby is behind it. But
that's funny. Probably true.
You live in Washington, you know. Question 4. One last multiple choice.
So wait, chaos. I'm winning though, right? It's 2-1.
I'm not gonna. It's not okay. For me to keep score. Our viewers are watching. Chaos hit Flagstaff, Arizona on Monday when a tanker truck flipped over, spilling 3,500 gallons of which liquid all over the highway? Was it A, chocolate, B, coffee, C, beer? Rachel.
Beer.
Was it C?
I don't know.
Beer.
I don't know.
3,500 gallons. That's how much liquid chocolate spilled in an Arizona interstate. A chocolate river, they described it, forming after a tanker carrying the candy crashed.
I just took a guess.
You don't think?
I knew I was losing, and I figured beer. Why would chocolate be on a
truck? You know what? You doubled down, and I admire that.
Okay. Listen, she's from Wisconsin, so of course she said beer.
Of course she said beer. cheese not being liquid. All right, final question. The Clemson Tigers invited to the White House for a candlelit feast to celebrate the recent victory over Alabama. What type of food did the president serve the team? Congressman Duffy.
I was there this morning, McDonald's. From the McDonald's that the food came from, I was there this morning.
Was it McDonald's?
We have pizzas, we have 300 hamburgers, many, many French fries, all of our favorite foods. I want to see what's here when we leave, because I don't think it's going to be much.
And Carlos owns the store.
And it wasn't, I just want to say, it wasn't exclusively, we're hearing from our judge, McDonald's. But McDonald's was represented. So,
oh.
And our, and you're right. You still win, because McDonald's was McDonald's, Wendy's, and what was the last one?
I was going to say fast food.
Burger King. So it was an ecumenical sort of
I just know that Carlos owns the McDonald's that gave the food to the White House.
So impressive. Congressman. Well,
he's had, look, it's been a shutdown. He's had a lot of downtime.
Exactly. But I would also say.
I've been home with the kids.
It really is.
Of course he knows.
It's a shared victory. It's really a victory for your family. We're pro-family on the show. So I'm going to award, in fact, our Eric Wemple commemorative mug to you, Rachel.
Thank you. Thank you, Tucker.
That was great. Congratulations to you both.
I went and watched the episode that you had with him on. It's great. YouTube it.
It really, when I'm feeling sad, sometimes I pull it up and it just,
smile.
Just kind of lifts me a
or
little.
Or if you're on a shutdown.
Exactly. That's right.
YouTube video.
It's amazing. It's like an animal.
All right.
All right. That's it for this week's final exam. Pay attention to the news all week. Come back Thursday to see if you can beat the expert.